You know, what I love about this next fight is that the UFC is really giving Carolina an opportunity. You know, she's 0-4 in her last four, but obviously fighting some of the toughest girls in the UFC. And can you believe this girl's already 35 years old? Not only does she always look 25 to me, but like, it just seems that we were just watching her in that elite Polish on Polish war with Joanna. And it's crazy to see where the career's gone since then. You know, so much potential, and she's just fought some of the best fighters. And all of a sudden, now 35 years old, we're calling Karolina Kowalkiewicz one of the pioneers. And speaking of pioneers, right, a true pioneer in Jessica Penne, first atomweight champion ever for Invicta. A lot of, you know, the types of fighters we see her on the first. She was the first. She was on the first card for Invicta, BJJ black belt. Like, the things that she brings to the table is very interesting for a fighter that's kind of making that semi-comeback right now. And in her fight against Lupita Godinez, a lot of people, right? Controversial decision. But we're seeing a lot of these different styles of judging where it's like whatever that person subjectively feels did more damage or in whatever control versus striking. And it looked like in that fight, they were giving the control a bit of an edge because Penne was just trying to make the most of the areas that she was able to keep Godinez in terms of, you know, locking her up in clinches and even having her, you know, between the legs and in triangle threats the whole time. But outside of that, I just think she's really, really fun to watch. The things that worried me, I mean, you talk about a girl like Carolina who, especially in the last few fights, just hasn't looked the same fighter, right? But in this one, if she can keep the distance, really work the striking, because if you look at the Jan fight, there was an eye injury, so she took a lot of damage, and then a lot of the groundwork came into play. If Jessica Penne is able to get this fight to the ground, I think that she's going to have her way with Carolina. She's going to have the strength. She's going to have the technique. And a lot of things that we've seen from Carolina, it's the stand-up wars. And so if she's not able to keep the fight there at a distance, using her really beautiful footwork and movement to get this fight in her favor, I think that we're going to see Penne really utilize that black belt and push it up against the fence, similar to the way she did with Lupita, and kind of eke out that decision-style victory if she can't finish via submission. I think that's the one area with when you watch Penne fight, she's always threatening, and that Alliance MMA, right? They have good game plans, and they're just good MMA fighters, and I think no matter where you see the fight, she really seems to have her way with a lot of girls, and that's, she's from that era where things were just always so close between all the fighters, and if it wasn't that way for every fight, I mean, I felt like with women's MMA, it was especially like that. And so in this fight right now, I really have to lean Penne just because of what we've seen recently. But Carolina has a striking game, right? So I'm going to say Penne by about minus 140 here. I don't think it can be more than that. It would be actually hella shocking if it was. And so let's take a look. Wow. Okay. Carolina, a consistent favorite since the opening line, minus 125 opener and pretty much a minus 135 favorite as we speak. Penne plus 105 opener and some places offering as high as plus 116. Very interesting. I think that Penne will have to use a lot of that ground game to exploit, you know, some of the weaknesses in Carolina. And if she's able to avoid that, then, you know, that striking game is really going to be tough for Penne to deal with for three rounds. But you know where Vegas lies. I'm actually going to go with Penne. I think that Penne has seen a bit of a resurgence here. I think that the action that we've seen recently from her spells for a pretty good outing here. And I think Carolina, just from what we've seen, how much more improvement can you make, right? So, I mean, I think I'm going to go with Penne. As always, if I don't stick with this one, check out Instagram for the final picks. But I do like Penne here. Twitter and Instagram, if you'd like, whichever is your cup of tea. But I'm leaning Penne, and I'm going to stick with that one for here, but let's see how it goes closer to crunch time.